Welcome to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. According to statistics, humans are most likely not alone in the universe. Fermi's paradox can help us think about this possibility. Alien civilizations may have already arisen, prospered, and become interplanetary, given the abundance of stars expected to have planets like Earth, where liquid water, life, and a moderate atmosphere, support life. Aliens may find traveling to other universes, as simple as going from home to the nearest McDonald's. If this is the case, we may not need to colonize faraway worlds in order to meet them. They might make an attempt to contact us. It's both terrifying and intriguing to consider, but how will aliens communicate with humanity? What would be the most effective manner for a technologically advanced alien civilization to announce its arrival throughout the galaxy? It could be to make its star system's planets dance in a mathematical sequence. Many searches for intelligent life have been carried out thus far, such as probing for radio signals or megastructures around stars, but the results have been vague and have natural explanations. That's why a scientist from France has proposed that we hunt for planets orbiting in precise patterns that could only have evolved purposefully. Their hypothesis is that a highly evolved civilization could alter the orbits of planets in its solar system to serve as a beacon of its presence to an observer from the outside. The gravitational pull of asteroids might be used to slowly move planets into new places over thousands of years, causing them to have full orbits, relative to one another, in a specific fixed ratio, or resonance. Natural gravitational interactions produce such resonances. For example, Jupiter's moon Io completes four Jupiter orbits for every two Europa orbits and one Ganymede orbit, forming a 2-to-1 resonance chain. Similar patterns have been observed in other star systems, although those in which the ratios of each body differ, rather than creating chains, have never been observed. As a result, the researchers believe aliens may organize their planets in sequences that are unlikely to occur naturally, such as a prime number series, or the Fibonacci sequence. The researchers calculated that these orbits may persist for 20 billion years before losing resonance, even surviving the demise of their host star. The concept is similar to colossal structures on Earth, such as ancient Egypt's tallest pyramids, which were built to last beyond the lifetime of a civilization. Similarly, this beacon has the potential to outlast its creators. Even if we did uncover such a sequence, it wouldn't prove intelligent life, and it's possible that the civilization behind it has long since vanished. But the relics of it might still be found. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy.
NASA is preparing to bring its Capstone spacecraft to launch soon and travel to the moon, and it will provide a massive stepping stone for the Artemis mission soon. The spacecraft is only the size of a microwave oven, and it weighs around 55 pounds only. Its main goal is to demonstrate an experimental orbit for the coming NASA Gateway, a lunar outpost for its future missions. Capstone is a CubeSat that NASA turned into a spacecraft that is only 55 pounds in mass and takes on the size of a microwave oven. According to NASA, the team is preparing to send a small satellite that will help the company determine massive information for its future Artemis mission. Capstone, which stands for Cislunar Autonomous Positioning System, Technology Operations, and Navigation Experiment, will help the company determine more about how the moon's orbit works. The Capstone satellite would be the first spacecraft that would look into this and bring answers to NASA that will help its future mission to the moon. The space agency is preparing to set up a lunar outpost on the moon in its upcoming mission towards it, but it would not send its spacecraft right then and there. It will focus on the Capstone that would bring answers to the lunar orbit before it goes on for the real deal. NASA's Gateway is the lunar outpost venture of the company for the upcoming Artemis moon mission, and it would help in setting up camp for the future. NASA is not shying away from showcasing many of the technology that will come for the Artemis moon mission, and it will focus on bringing the public much information about all things regarding the upcoming venture. One of the latest ventures of NASA is the wet dress rehearsal of the Space Launch System, SLS, rocket bound for the moon. The company is also focusing on transportation methods that will be available while on the lunar surface, and not only a vehicle that will take them from the planet to its natural satellite. A planned electric vehicle is coming to replace the 1980s Astro van, and it is with EV manufacturer Canoe to fulfill the car's design and technology come to its mission. Of course, NASA is also preparing its astronaut candidates for the Artemis mission, as it would bring the first woman to the moon. Many preparations are set in place to ready the upcoming mission, as it would be a significant one, as it would be the return to the moon after several decades since the last. Capstone will help set up a massive advancement on the future moon mission, and it will do so despite it being a small spacecraft. Before Gateway launches for its purpose, the Capstone will provide an experimental test on its orbit. We cannot wait for the Artemis mission to kick off. About you? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because in space we trust. Recently, our planet has had many surprise visitors, in the form of asteroids and comets. Don't you think it's about time we visited one? A perfect opportunity has risen, as a large asteroid is hurtling towards Earth. Because of its size and the proximity of its potential visit to Earth, the stadium-sized asteroid Apophis has been one of the most concerning space rocks on Earth's radar. With the recent announcement by NASA that the asteroid-bumping spacecraft OSIRIS-REx will pay it a visit, we'll learn a lot more about it. OSIRIS-REx is already well known for its daring mission to collect a sample from the asteroid Bennu in 2020. The spaceship is en route back to Earth, where it will drop off the sample for scientists to examine. It will then embark on an extended mission to Apophis, once that assignment is completed. The Bennu sample will be delivered in September 2023. Apophis has a diameter of around 1,200 feet, and will pass within 20,000 miles of Earth in 2029. That'll be a close but safe shave. NASA also ruled out the possibility of an asteroid colliding with Earth in 2068, which had been a source of anxiety. The spacecraft is one of 8 NASA-funded planetary scientific projects to receive extensions. A number of Mars missions are included in this group, including the Curiosity rover and the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter. OSIRIS-REx will get up close and personal with its prospective asteroid target around the time the space rock makes a very close approach to Earth, in 2029. Reflecting on its new mission, OSIRIS-REx will be renamed OSIRIS-APEX, in light of its new aim. Instead of taking a sample from Apophis, OSIRIS-APEX will snuggle up to it and fire its thrusters at the surface, exposing the stuff beneath. It's possible that OSIRIS-APEX isn't the only spacecraft that will approach Apophis. Scientists from South Korea also hope to launch a mission. The asteroid's imminent close approach will provide a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to obtain a close look at a possibly dangerous asteroid. The more we know, the better prepared we will be for future threats. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy.